private sector, if the individual is entering to the government at the higher position, this is called as lateral entry, and this recruitment is supposed to be happened by the UPSC only. Come to the discussion. I have already told you, Center asked the UPSC to cancel the recent advertisement that has been come for the 45 posts to be filled through the lateral entry. And this article also says, like, after black backlash, union government orders the cancellation of the lateral recruitment. You need to understand what is lateral entry. Although there is a basically criteria in the government, you reach to the higher positions through the promotion only. But through the lateral entry, we are directly entering the private sector individuals at the higher positions. And this is called as the lateral entry. So from the private sector, if the individual is entering to the government at the higher position, this is called as lateral entry, and this recruitment is supposed to be happened by the UPSC only. And lateral entry, why it was required and what is the benefit of the lateral entry, you need to understand. Actually, there is a topic called civil services reforms. So basically, where it can be asked about the lateral entry, as in GS2 syllabus, civil services reforms is being given. So in that, they can ask what about lateral entry, whether lateral entry to be introduced in India or not, why it is required, and what are the basically disadvantages of it. So benefits could be, as there is a shortage of civil servants to fulfill the requirement of the civil servants, this can help us. So basically, shortage of the civil servants at the higher positions can be filled up by the private sector, and moreover, private sector brings the expertise and experience. And in fact, in the GS4 ethics, you read about the public sector and the private sector work ethics, you read about it, and you also read in the private sector there is a more efficiency and competitive skills and the same experience and the domain experience. Basically, like, civil servants are generalists in nature, as we read general studies. And for example, IRS, Indian Revenue Services, these are not to be filled by the CAs or the CS individuals, but rather it can be filled by any of the position. He could be engineer as well. So to bring more efficiency and domain expertise, what we can do is to bring the basically experienced CA, chartered accountants, into the Indian Revenue Services. So this way, more efficiency can be brought into the governance as well. So these two basically can be filled up. The shortage and the domain expertise can be fulfilled in the public services. But the disadvantages could be, first thing is the culture and the bureaucratic culture. This has to be tackled, because this will bring lot of debate, as lateral entry will definitely hit civil services examination criteria, because they are not basically facing the same examination of the competition to reach to the higher positions. And the other thing, it is also basically against the reservation policy, as the reservation to the basically communities will be not there in the lateral entry. So it will be against the reservation. And the other thing, there could be a bias in the appointments, as there could be a basically back entry of the private individuals into the basically public sector. And moreover, those public private sector individuals will have the short-term goals. So they will not basically focus on the long-term commitment to the public service, rather they will have a short-term goal, because in the lateral entry they will be hired for 3 to 5 years, and moreover they are not being sure of the bureaucratic culture. They will not be able to adjust to that culture. This will be difficult for them. So there could be a bias in the appointments. I hope the discussion is clear to you why this is in news, lateral entry, and where it can be asked. Yes, to civil services reforms. And the other thing is you need to prepare about the benefits and disadvantages.